Enjoy your Christmas as well.
You too, Queen.
Thank you, bye.
Yes, ma'am. Yeah, nigga, I know you niggas. What you doing, nigga? The black women love me. You niggas don't get no love from the black woman, nigga. You niggas don't get no love from the single women, nigga. Because you niggas don't show no example of a good stand-up man. They love to come to the internet and hear Trump say to you bullshit-ass niggas, to you weak-ass niggas. And I really live it. I really live like this. I'm really a father to my kids. The day one daddy, nigga, I ain't never been to jail on my kids. Yeah, don't block me, Unc. Please. You just got blocked, nigga. Your ass is blocked, bitch ass nigga. And you know why I'm blocking you? Because you done acted like a hoe so long in here. You done talked all that motherfucking shit, nigga. You done talk all that motherfucking shit like you a bad ass nigga and you a tough ass nigga. Now you wanna holler, don't block me, Unc, please. Signs of a bitch ass nigga, man. You got to go, sucker. Cause yeah, you got to get your bitch ass out of here, boy. Yeah, you got to get out of here, nigga. Bitch ass nigga, do all that goddamn talking. All that roughing, all that goddamn barking up this goddamn tree, and then wanna say, don't block me. Nigga, if you bitch ass, and I'm telling you, we're those social media niggas, man. I'm telling you, nigga, I love getting on here, and I love making you niggas come to this light. You niggas can't get in front of the sun. You see how that sun, you niggas ain't, your skin ain't this pretty for one, nigga. Your niggas skin ain't this motherfucking handsome and smooth and got that glow like that pregnant hoe, nigga. You niggas got acne and bad bumps on your face, and you niggas can't handle this kind of attention. The average nigga break up under this kind of pressure. Nigga motherfucker hating on them like this and talking about your eye and talking about your head and talking about your lips and talking about your nose. You niggas don't have no comeback for this, and I got a comeback for everything. I got a comeback for everything, nigga. Unknown loner sent a request. Come on in, unknown loner. Come on in. Area, come on in. Yeah, we open the flow up right now. We opening the flow up, goddamn it, rat motherfucking now. Yeah, and you niggas, I know y'all hate a real nigga. Y'all been hating real niggas. Y'all been happy niggas once going to jail. Y'all been happy niggas been get death penalties, nigga, and getting killed, nigga. Cause you niggas got to take second place. You niggas got to take second place. You're taking too long to come on in, baby. We'll catch you another time. Yeah, you nigga got to take second place to a nigga like me, nigga. All my life, nigga, I've been the most popular nigga in school. All my life, nigga, I've been the most popular nigga in school, in middle school, elementary, nigga. Yeah, you nigga don't know what it feel like, nigga, for all the pretty little girls in school to like you, nigga. You nigga don't know what it feel like for all the pretty little girls in school to like you from elementary all the way through middle school, nigga.
Hey, Charles,
yeah. Charles. Say, what's up with the black man?
What's up, man? What's up, man?
Hey. Before you say anything, this is what I want to put on your brain, nigga.
Nah.
Yeah, nigga, they call me Comeback Charleston Blue. That's my real family nickname, nigga, Charleston Blue, right? And so as I got older, this is what I realized the blue stands for, nigga. Black love unifies everyone. Nigga, if black people want to loving on each other, nigga, we'll unify white folks.
Yes,
we'll
sir.
Unify Mexicans.
Yes,
all they need to do, nigga, see us love on each other, nigga, like we love on Michael Jordan tennis shoes, nigga.
Yes, sir. Hey, I ain't gonna lie to you. I be watching you for a minute, bro. Like when I see you stand up to them niggas at that rally, I was like, oh, this nigga really got these niggas shook out here. He really got this.
Yeah, homie, and them was all the G niggas. A lot of niggas be hollering, oh, them was the Black Lives Matter people. Say, homie, them was all the G niggas from the South Side, the East Side, Stop Six, Echo Heights, the North Side. Nigga, it was all, and them niggas had AKs, AR, 223. Them niggas had everything. Nigga, I only had a knife in my pocket. But, nigga, it's the protection of God. Nigga, it's that hedge of protection around me, homie.
Yeah.
I literally walk with a hedge of protection from the Creator, homie, where niggas can't touch me, homie.
Yeah. But I just want to know, like, what be making you be going off on these people like that? Like, why you really just treating them like
that? Well, this why, homie. I started out 10 years ago, I started out just speaking in the churches, right? I would come to churches and I would talk at the church to the youth congregation, the youth ministers.
Yeah.
From the churches, I started working and talking inside of the local juvenile detention centers. From there, I started working at the state at the state level, at the maximum security juvenile prisons, the Texas Juvenile Justice Department. And I started seeing, homie, all the pain of the black children. All the pain of the black children come from a lack of a father. All the pain from the black woman come from the father. Right? So then from there, nigga, it's all right. Nigga, y'all quit hating. That nigga can record. That nigga trying to get some good footage. I'm one of the hottest niggas in the country right now. So let that nigga get some free footage, nigga. And I'm one of the hottest niggas in the country. So, nigga, this is good video. So keep recording, homie. Yeah. So I started working not in just the juvenile systems. Then I started working at the middle schools and the high school, teaching classes at the alternative schools. So then I started teaching classes at the adult office over off McCart to every nigga that got out of prison, homie. For a whole year, every nigga who got out of prison, they would have to come to my class every Tuesday at the adult parole office. So, nigga, I started signing niggas up that was getting out of prison, signing them niggas up to college. So, nigga, I started seeing the plight. I started seeing the plight of our community, homie. I started hearing young niggas whose fathers went to jail, and while their father was in prison, they was being molested by their mom's brother, their uncles. I started hearing stories about young niggas when I work on a capital murder case. When I work on a capital murder case, man, with the public defender's office, and we trying to stop this young nigga from getting a death penalty or getting life, and we have to present what they call mitigating circumstances and mitigating factors in order to get this young brother's life spared. I started finding out that all the young niggas that's doing the killing, they got all the anger problems. Nigga, most of them niggas been sexually molested.
Yeah.
Either by their mom's boyfriend, which was a stepdad, or they spent the night over somebody's house and they were molested by their friend's dad. So I start seeing, homie, nigga, the young boys is being molested. The young boys is fucked up. That's why all these young niggas is killers. But we don't know this until these niggas kill somebody and now they facing life. And they facing the death penalty, and now they want to spare. They want to get their life spared, and so now they telling the truth about what happened to them growing up.
Yeah.
So working with the CPS Child Protective Services, man, working with the U.S. Department of Homeland Security, partnering with the Texas Juvenile Justice Department, working with gang unit, homie, traveling to Washington D.C., working with over 50 U.S. congressional members, homie. And so I've done this. I've been a community leader, a community activist. I've been a youth advocate, a youth justice leader. I train, I teach, I volunteer. I run a highly recommended youth organization in Fort Worth, homie. And don't know niggas, don't know OG niggas.
They'll step in.
Don't know OG niggas help in the city, homie. All these niggas kill. All these niggas take. So then when the young niggas get killed, who you think helping the mama and them raise money for the family to bury these niggas? Not the hood niggas. So that's why I talk to these niggas like this, homie, because I've been in the community doing the work and everybody's on the internet talking and nobody is in the community working. They wait till a Black Lives Matter shooting happens, then they want a Black Lives Matter. But nigga, we got 200 shootings in the city and don't nobody say nothing. When these niggas mistakenly shoot up the wrong house, who you think at that house, nigga, making sure that house get repaired? Who you think, nigga? Me.
Yeah.
So I'm checking this bullshit, nigga. Yeah, I sold dope too, nigga, but we sold dope, nigga.
Yeah.
You ain't get your mama out the hood to sell dope, so what you sold dope for, nigga?
What?
Your mama didn't need that money. So, nigga, I talk this shit, nigga, because I live this shit, nigga. And plus, I went to jail for killing a white man. I don't know too many other niggas that was done time for killing no pepperwood, homie. So I'm a different kind of nigga than these niggas. See, I was tricked into the gangbanger, nigga, and I was an elite gangbanger. I was an elite crip. And I realized them niggas tricked us, homie. I realized them niggas tricked us. So all these internet niggas do the talking, that's why I handle these niggas on the internet like this. Because these niggas on the internet talking, and they ain't shit in person.
Yeah.
See, I'm really somebody in person, nigga. I'm really a big dog in person. And I've earned the right to speak to my community and speak to my race of people the way I speak to my race of people. Because, nigga, I really live this shit, my nigga. So I appreciate you for giving me the opportunity to explain myself on why I talk to these sucker-ass niggas.
Appreciate
these social media sucker-ass niggas. Because all my niggas is killers. And there's 60 of us. All 60 of us committed a murder when we was children, homie. And we're all living productive and pro-social lives today. And we get back to our communities. And we are the leaders in our cities.
Yeah. Appreciate it, bro. I just wanted to know, bro. Appreciate it for putting me alive.
Hold on. I can't hear you.
I appreciate it.